Hello students, welcome back to effortless chemistry. Already we have started group 15 of the p block element. In the last session we have discussed up to oxidation state. Now we will continue the remaining part. Now we will discuss the reaction of group 15 elements with hydrogen. This is a group 15 element which is electronegative, and hydrogen is what? Electropositive. Electropositive oxidation state is plus 1, electronegative is what here? This is minus 3, so that it will form EH3 type of the hydrides. Always you keep in mind, for the group 15 element, 5 valence electrons are there. Out of 5, one lone pair of electron is there, and remaining 3 unpaired electrons are there. By using 3 unpaired electrons, it will form a 3 bond with a hydrogen, and one lone pair of electron is always available on the central atom here. Now we will write group 15 hydrides. This is I'll write NH3, PH3, ASH3, SBH3, and this is BiH3. In each hydride, there is a lone pair of electrons present on the central atom. Now we will discuss thermal stability. Out of these hydrides, which hydrides are more stable? You keep in mind one thing, in a molecule, suppose both atoms are small size, stable. Suppose both atoms are large size, stable. Large size combination, stable. Small size combination is what? Again, stable. Suppose one atom is large and one is small. One atom is small and another is large. This type of combination is unstable. And this type of combination is what here? This is stable combination. Okay. Now we know that down the group, atomic size increases from nitrogen to bismuth. Now, nitrogen and hydrogen almost same size. Phosphorus size increases. Here, arsenic size increases. Antimony size increases. Bismuth is largest size in the group 15. As the size difference between the atom increases, their stability decreases. This type of combination is unstable, and this type of combination is what here? Stable. That's why with the help of this one, we can predict the stability of the group 15 hydrides. Among the group 15 hydrides, the stability decreases down the group with increase in the size of the atom from nitrogen to bismuth. BiH3 is the least stable due to a large difference between the size of the bismuth and hydrogen. Down the group, what happens? As the size of the atom is increasing, their ability to form the stable bond with the hydrogen decreases. See here, as the atom size is increasing, their bond length also increases. Among these hydrides, what happens here? BiH bond is longer bond here. And this is NH bond is what here? Shorter bond. As the bond length increases, its strength decreases, and this bond can be easily broken, so that this is more reactive and less stable. So that what happens here, down the group, the stability of the hydride, thermal stability of the hydride decreases. NH3 is the more stable hydride among the group 15 elements. This is the order of thermal stability of the group 15 hydrides. Next one, now in the hydrides, the central atom is having what here? Lone pair of electrons. Due to presence of lone pair of electrons on the central atom, these hydrides, they will act as what? Lewis base here. So what is the Lewis base here? Lewis base is the species which can donate a lone pair of electron. Hence, these are having what lone pair of electron means? They are acting as what? Lewis base. Among the group 15 hydrides, ammonia is the strongest base and BiH3 is what? Weakest base. Down the group, the basic nature of the hydrides decreases. Here, in case of nitrogen, what happens? Because of its small size, the lone pair of electrons are concentrated on the small region. That's why they are easily available to donate towards the other species. But if you go for other hydrides, as the atomic size increases, the lone pair of electrons are what? They are scattered over large region. Because of that, they are not easily available for the donation. Hence, down the group, with increase in the atomic size, again their basic nature also decreases. This ammonia is what here? Strong base. Ammonia is strong base here. So this is what the order of basic nature of the hydrides. For thermal stability and basic nature, you will get the same order. Down the group, the thermal stability as well as basic nature of these hydrides decreases. Next point is reducing nature of these hydrides. Reducing nature is inversely proportional to the stability. Reducing nature is what? Inversely proportional to the stability. That's why among the group 15 hydrides, BiH3 is the strongest reducing agent because of the large size difference between the bismuth and hydrogen. It is having what? Least stable bond here. Because of that, what happens? This bond can be easily broken. It gives that hydrogen easily. That's why this is the strongest reducing agent here. And this is what? Weak reducing agent. So the reducing nature is what? Inversely proportional to stability. Least stable, strongest reducing agent. More stable, weakest reducing agent here. Okay. Now we will write the order of reducing nature of the group 15 members. That is reducing nature. Reducing nature increases down the group with increase in the size of the atom. This is Pi, this is PH3, and this is ASH3, and this is SbH3, and this is what here? BiH3. Okay. So this is what the order of reducing nature of the group 15 hydrides. One thing you keep in mind, among the group 15 hydrides, this BiH3 is what? Strong reducing agent. And this ammonia is what here? Due to presence of lone pair of electrons. Here also lone pair of electrons are there, but they are not easily available. Here, because of the small size of the nitrogen, that electron density is concentrated in the small region. That's why they are easily available to donate towards the other species here. So this becomes as what here? Strong base. Among the group 15 hydrides, ammonia is a strong base, and BiH3 is what? Strong reducing agent. This is what? Thermal stability, basic nature, and reducing nature of the group 15 hydrides. Now we'll discuss melting point, boiling point, and the structure of these hydrides. Now we will discuss the melting and boiling point of these hydrides. For right, NH3, this is a PH3, ASH3, SbH3, and this is BiH3. Melting point and boiling point of these hydrides increases down the group with increase in the size of the atoms. From PH3 and ASH3, SbH3 and BiH3, down the group, what happens here? Boiling point and melting point, both I will write. Boiling point and melting point increases down the group. What is the reason for the increase in the boiling point and melting point down the group? Reason is what here? Due to increase in molecular size. That is nothing but down the group, atomic size increases means the molecular size also increases. Due to increase in the molecular size, van der Waals force of attraction increases. Van der Waals force of attraction increases. Hence, boiling point and melting point increases down the group. But one thing you have to keep in mind, the boiling point and the melting point of the ammonia is greater than that of the phosphine PH3 here. This is because of, due to small size and high electronegativity of the nitrogen atom, it is involved in the hydrogen bonding. Due to presence of the hydrogen bonding in the ammonia, its melting point and boiling point is higher than that of the remaining hydrides. This is especially, it is greater than that of what? PH3 or remaining hydrides, because these hydrides, they are not able to form hydrogen bonding. So for the remaining hydrides, from phosphorus to bismuth, what happens? their melting point and boiling point increases down the group. Because of increase in the molecular size, van der Waals force of attraction increases. Hence, what happens? Melting and boiling point is increasing here. But one point you have to keep in mind here. For ammonia, the melting point and boiling point is greater than that of what? PH3 here. The reason for this one is, due to small size and high electronegativity of the nitrogen atom, it is involved in the intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Due to presence of intermolecular hydrogen bonding in case of ammonia, its boiling point and melting point is greater than the remaining hydrides, because the remaining hydrides are not able to form the hydrogen bond. So this is what melting point and boiling point of the hydrides. Always you keep in mind, this is involved in what? Hydrogen bonding. You can see here, what is hydrogen bonding? It is the force of attraction between the highest electronegative element with the hydrogen. That's it. This is like this it is. Only fluorine, oxygen and nitrogen, they are involved in the hydrogen bonding. So that this nitrogen is involved in what? Hydrogen bonding with the hydrogen. So this is, I will call it as nitrogen, and this is three hydrogens, and I will call this as hydrogen, and this is hydrogen. This is what? Lone pair of electron. Between these two, what happens here? Hydrogen bonding is formed. Due to formation of this intermolecular hydrogen bonding, what happens? In case of ammonia, the force of attraction between the molecule increases. That's why their melting point and boiling point increases here. This is what? Melting point and boiling point of the hydrides. Next, we will go for structure of these hydrides. What is the structure of hydride here? This is a EH3 type of the molecule. So that one lone pair of electron is present in the central atom here. And these are what? sp3 hybrid. One lone pair of electron is there, and three sigma bonds are there. The presence of three sigma bond and one lone pair is what here? This is sp3 hybrid. Due to presence of one lone pair of electron, these hydrides are having what? Pyramidal shape. And these are the three hydrogen. And the bond angle, due to increased repulsion among lone pair and bond pair, what happens here? The bond angle decreases to nearly 170°. Okay. So what happens here? The bond angle of remaining hydrides NH3, PH3, and this is ASH3, and this is SbH3, and this is BiH3. Okay. Here the bond angle is 107, and here the bond angle is 93.5, and this is 91.5, and this is 91.3, and this is around 90. Okay. See here, down the group, what happens here? Bond angle is decreasing. See here, with increase in the electronegativity of the central atom, bond angle is increasing. Always you keep in mind, for the remaining hydrides, the bond angle is nearly about 90°. But in case of ammonia, because of its high electronegativity, what happens? The bond angle is increasing. Bond angle is directly proportional to what? Electronegativity of central atom. As the electronegativity of the central atom is increasing, here bond angle is increasing. All these hydrides are having what? Pyramidal shape with the sp3 hybridization. One lone pair, three sigma bonds are there. So the bond angle is nearly 107 for this one. For remaining hydrides, that bond angle is decreasing because of decrease in the electronegativity. This is about hydrides of group 15. Now we will discuss the oxides of group 15 elements. Oxides of group 15 elements. Already we know that this is, if you take as a group 15 element, and this is the oxygen. Oxygen being more electronegative than group 15 element, because oxygen is present at the right hand side, and group 15 elements are what? Left hand side. Left hand side electropositive, right hand side is what? Electronegative. So that oxygen will show what? -2 oxidation state. So for a group 15 element, you have to take what? Positive oxidation state. Already we know the common oxidation state, -3, +3 and +5. How many oxidation states are possible in the positive? This is a +3 also possible. Another possibility is there. Another possibility is there, that is plus 5 oxidation state with the oxygen. So these group 15 elements, they will form two types of oxide, that is one is E2O3 and another is what here, they will form E2O5. So that group 15 elements with oxygen, they will form two types of oxide, E2O3 and E2O5. Now we will write the oxides, that is I will write N2O3, that is E2O3 type of oxides, I will write P2O3, AS2O3, SB2O3 and Bi2O3. Next one, pentoxides, I will write N2O5, P2O5 and this is AS2O5 and this is SB2O5 and this is Bi2O5. These are the trioxides and these are what? Pentoxides. Already in the periodic properties we know that non-metal plus oxygen is what? Acidic. Non-metal oxides are what? Acidic in nature. Metal plus oxygen is what here? Metal oxides are what? Basic in nature. Suppose metalloid is there. Metalloid plus oxygen is what here? They are amphoteric in nature. They are what? Amphoteric in nature. Already we know that these two elements are what? Nitrogen and phosphorus are non-metals. Arsenic and antimony are what? Metalloids. And bismuth is what? Metal. Metal oxide is what? Basic. Metal oxide is basic. Non-metal oxides are what here? Acidic. And a metalloid with oxygen is what here? They are amphoteric in nature. They are what? Amphoteric. So non-metal oxides are acidic, metalloid with oxygen is what? Amphoteric, and metal with oxygen is basic in nature. Similarly, in case of pentoxide also, these two are acidic in nature, these two are amphoteric in nature, and this is what? Basic in nature here. Again, this is what? Basic in the nature. So down the group, what happens? Among the group 15 oxides, down the group, acidic nature decreases and basic nature increases, because bismuth is metal, means metal oxide is always basic in nature. These two are non-metals. Non-metal oxides are what? Acidic in nature. Therefore, down the group, acidic nature of oxides decreases and basic nature of oxides increases. This is what the point about trioxides and pentoxides. And another point is there, in these group 15 elements, nitrogen forms 5 types of oxides, but the remaining elements, they will form what? Only two types of oxide, that is E2O3 and E2O5 type of the oxide. In case of group 15, nitrogen forms 5 types of oxides, but the remaining elements, they will form only two types of oxide, that is E2O3 and E2O5 type of the oxide. But here nitrogen is forming what? 5 types of oxide. We will see that one. Next point. Now, nitrogen forms 5 oxides, nitrogen plus oxygen. So that 5 types of oxides are formed, N2O, N2O2, this is nothing but dimeric form of NO, 2 times of NO combined together to form what? N2O2. The next oxide is N2O3, next one is N2O4, this is the dimeric form of what? NO2, 2 times of NO2 combined together to form what? N2O4. The next oxide is N2O5. So in this one, the oxidation state of nitrogen is plus 1, and here it is plus 2, and this is a plus 3, and this is a plus 4, and this is plus 5. For the oxides of same element, the acidic nature is directly proportional to the oxidation state. Higher the oxidation state, more acidic is the oxide. In this one, what happens here? Oxidation state is highest in case of what? N2O5. That's why acidic nature increases from what? +1 to +5 oxidation state. For oxides of same element, for the oxides of same element, acidic nature, is directly proportional to the oxidation state. Oxidation state increases, acidic nature increases. That's why among these oxides, N2O5 is what? Strongest acid. So in this direction, what happens? Acidic nature is decreasing. This is what the oxides of group 15 elements.